John, you're going to stand for a round of applause, please.
Everyone else, stand up. Yes, this is the way I look. Free Kentucky Fried Chicken for everyone. It's a little about chicken, huh? You want to have a drink here? Is that a drink? Now, I'm going to buy one of them water filters. Put it back, yeah, I was fucking worried, man. Don't worry, Beefy. You need your booze. I haven't had a drink since Christmas. I had one of them nights. I haven't had one for a long time, but I woke up the next day and I went, what the fuck happened the night before? Oh, that's fucking nice. Have you had, what's your name, sir?
Maybe tomorrow, yeah.
Your name is Maybe Tomorrow. The priest of baptology must have been fucking out of his head now. Your parents don't. What the hell is Dave? Maybe Tomorrow. Fuck. Oh, that's his name. Maybe Tomorrow. Fuck. Maybe Tomorrow. You tell me you yesterday, eh? The future, the past. You wake up. Have you had one of them days so you wake up and can't remember what happened? What's your name? Sorry?
Dan.
It's fucking days you wake up, you go, what the fuck? And you have to try and find out what happened the night before by ringing your friends and not asking them what happened the night before. You can't fucking ask them because you don't want to know. You're trying to tell by the tone of their voice. And how are you, John? Oh, yeah. Yeah, good night last night. Yeah, it was great, was it? I mean, it was great. That's great, we'll see it again sometime. Fucking got away with it. Now I've got to ring my Auntie Maureen. I hope I didn't have sex with her again. That was some fucking night. Those nights when you drink too much, you go fucking man. You often begin with the sentence, will we go for one? Nobody's ever gone for fucking one. People who go for one don't number the number of drinks they're gonna have. They just go for a drink. People who say we'll go for one is just a fucking alibi. But the next day when they're wrecked, they go, well listen, we tried to go for one. A drink wouldn't let us. A few years ago on RTE, they did an ad on TV, just stop with drinking too much. The tagline was, know the one that's one too many. Know the one that's one too many. I wish I knew the one that was one. Because that's the first drink I'd order on a night out. He'd save a fortune. Going to the pub, or goes, what do you want? Not the one that's one too many. Barman's going, I shouldn't give you this. Thanks very much, you fucking cunt. I Because you want to be sensible, you want to be sensible, but then you want to go mental. There's that tension, isn't it? Fucking have a nice night out, be fucking sensible. Go fucking nuts. That tension is in Irish dancing. You can see it. The top half is so fucking sensible, isn't it? The top half's like a going for one.
Storm Ophelia is shit. If they were
say, seriously, they should give the storms different names. The next storm, they should call it something like Tommy the Fucker. If they knew Tommy the Fucker was coming, they wouldn't be swimming out of the sea. Tommy the Fucker's coming, lock the doors, I'm not going out. It's Tommy the Fucker. Tomorrow's bad, Kieran on the cunt's on the way. Trump, huh? What do you think about Trump?
Wake up!
You're a ventriloquist as well. What's your name?
Jono.
Jono. Are you getting married, are you? Are you the stag, are you? Are you? He was so shocked when he said he'd get married. I was like, fuck, what's happening, man? What's that? Trump's a prick. He's not a prick, he's fucking conny, man. Look at Trump, he's great. Look at him and going, what? There's so many questions. You're just going, what the fuck are you? Even what colour are you? One minute he's red, then he's orange, then he's yellow. Sometimes he's so yellow, I'm looking at him and going, he could actually be in The Simpsons as himself. They wouldn't have to draw him, you could act in the fucking Simpsons. He's like the colour of a 20-year-old pillow. Oh yeah, you're all one of them dirty things, aren't they? Everybody in Ireland's got a dirty, manky fucking pillow. A dirty old man's yellow teeth coloured pillow. We're all snuggling down to sleep in a manky fuck bag. We passed them on from generation to generation. They're disgusting. But do we change them? Do we fuck? We buy new pillowcases to cover them all. Cover that shit over. Dirty, manky fucking Trump's weird. There's nothing sticks to him. He can do anything. Well, the presidents were going down. Even when he came out first, MI6 came out and said, this thing about Russian prostitutes. Did you hear that story maybe tomorrow? Your life's going to be a misery from now on with your friends, isn't it? Did you hear the story about Trump and the Russian prostitutes? That was so passive aggressive. No, tell me, please. Said maybe tomorrow. Hey, come out. Did anybody hear? Anybody hear about the Joanna? Did you hear about the Russian prostitutes?
Joanna.
Yeah, you're Joanna, aren't you?
Thanks, Neil.
Nah, it's fucking Joanna now. Did you hear about the Russian prostitutes, man? You what?
No, but
he what?
Loved it.
He loved it. He never heard the story, but he fucking loved it. That is brilliant. You're the only person who doesn't have experiences, but hey, that was fucking brilliant. I must do that thing again that I never fucking did in the first place. I'll tell you that. The Russian prostitutes apparently they pissed on Trump. Who heard that? Yeah, Russian prostitutes pissed on fucking Trump. And then Trump came out and said, no, that's not true. The interesting thing about that is not whether it's true or false, but the fact that people heard that story and went, yeah, that sounds reasonably possible. That's a measure of where he is as a president. People go, yeah, Russian prostitutes probably pissed on the American president. I think they did, that's why he's so yellow. Trump. One story he doesn't want anybody to know, and I'm going to tell you here tonight. Trump was in Ireland in the 1960s, and he did a modeling job. And he's shitting it that anybody can find out about it. But I've got a picture. I have a picture to show you from that modern guy. He's like a cross between starch and fascism. Theresa May. It's that old beach there. I miss Theresa May. Yeah, it's a photo world, man. I'm trying to be positive. Are you positive? Are you positive? Mr. Hands held together so tightly that you're going to crush your own fucking body. What's your name? Jimmy, are you positive, yeah? Yeah, try to be. I try to be. It's hard for Irish people. My granny, she was like, fucking, she's tried to be. She said, Kevin, the glass is half full of piss. They say what you gotta do is take a negative situation and make it positive. So I did that recently. Fucking air rang me up and he said, Mr. Billy, your bill is outstanding. Oh, thanks very much. I think it's pretty good too, depends on the bottom. The world will never be better unless we're positive in our own minds. I grew up in Sligo, the middle of fucking nowhere. Really, the middle of fucking nowhere. 3 miles from the local town, which had 1,000 people in it. But for us, it was like fucking New York, man. It was like the Big Island. We used to go in once a week to do the shopping, and we're all excited, going, we're off to the big potato. Now the first time I arrived there, I was so naive, because all the townies, we called them townies, they were like fucking hard and sophisticated, right? We weren't like folk. But to me, I grew up in the middle. So I'm walking down the street, 8 years old, and this townie just goes to me and he said, hello. And I was like, hello. And then he said, not you, the wall. I was like, fuck. I was so naive, I thought he was actually having a chat with the fucking wall. But next week it happened, I'm walking along, hello, not you, the wall. Then I realised, he's a fucking prick. And that happened every time, and it really hurt me. It's like eventually I stopped going into town, because this guy, every time he said hello, not you, the wall, he's like, upset. I was thinking, I'm 50 now, I'd like to go back and meet that kind of stuff. I genuinely explained, put it to bed, explained to him how it made me feel. I'd like to sit him down. I'd have a brick. And I'd be the shit out of it while repeating the words, you say hello to the wall. My dad, he was a painter and decorator. He painted houses and shit. But I remember once, times were a bit hard, so he turned his hand to face painting. And he was really quick. Kids go, I want to be Spider-Man, shut up, you know, whoa. I think it's funny, I get 50, I started thinking back at this shit, you know. Started thinking about, I get 50. I get interested in stuff I never gave a shit about before. The biggest thrill I get these days is hanging up the most amount of washing with the least amount of heads. What a fucking day that is. My record is one peg, 17 pairs of underpants. Takes the ages to dry. I was never sick. I hit 50. I got fucking sick. It was shit, man. I got diabetes type 2. But diabetes 2 is bad because it's a sequel. every single day. I have to take a tablet every day. So you think if you're on tablets every day, side effects wouldn't be that bad, would they? A bit of headache, a bit of nausea. This is absolutely true. I have a 1 in 1,000 chance of getting an itchy vagina. That's absolutely true. I cannot convey to you the horror of reading you an itchy vagina in a list of side effects. You go, what the fuck are they putting in these tablets? I went to the doctor and said, I'm not fucking taking these. It's going to be handy, you've got diabetes. So now. I am a warning from the future. Take heed now, maybe tomorrow. Not maybe tomorrow, change your ways fucking today. I stand naked in front of the mirror. It's gone fucking quiet now. My testicles look like haunted Christmas tree balls. Everything down there looks like a Robin Redbreast with his head punched in. It's like I'm riding a space hop with all the air that out of it. It's got one handle. I'm married, I've got 2 kids. Give me a shout, you got kids? Have you got kids?
Yeah.
What age is it?
7.
11?
7.
7, they're all 7. It's a tip, right? My kids are 12 and 14. If you've got kids, first 5 years of their lives, you will get no sleep at all. So here's my tip for you. I love the way you nod at me every time that I got. Yeah, it's not funny, but it's fucking true. Here's my tip. You will get no sleep. So my tip is Calpol. I'm telling you, half a bottle of Calpol. I went straight to sleep. Didn't give a shit. When you got kids, you gotta make an effort. You gotta remember we have date nights. Do you, is this a date night?
Yeah.
Yeah. You have date nights.
Yeah.
We do too. We used to, myself and my wife had a date night. We went to the cinema, 50 Shades Darker. Well, she went to see that. I want to see Batman the Lego movie. It's hard when you got kids, it's fucking stressful. We have a lot of fucking arguments. I'm not kidding, we argue, we've got 2 kids. We're that close to sitting on each other's faces. And farting. Sometimes we don't talk, we have to leave each other notes around the house. I made you a cup of tea. It's in the fridge. So who are you married? Are you married? Are you with somebody? Are you married with him? What's your name again? Jimmy. Because kids are stressful and you have a lot of arguments, man. Don't you, Jimmy? I'm married 14 years, so I look at arguments as a chance to have sex. Because after the argument, the air is clear, they go, you know, recently I said to my wife, I said, listen, will you give me a hand job? Straight in, no messing. That's not a lot to ask for Jimmy, is it? Hand job. But that's low entry level. It's just a fucking hand job. But she was like, no, I was like, give us a hand job. And he can fix the back door. Fuck off with your shit jokes, wouldn't you? So she gave me a hand job, right? Big deal about it. It's a fucking hand job. But it's just a hand job. I'm so fucking excited. Oh yeah, I'm going, yeah, I'm a man. I'm a lion, I'm king of the jungle. Oh, I'm like a woman from a 70s shampoo ad. Stevie Wonder on ecstasy. I'm fucking excited, man. I'm a man. My wife, by contrast, she's given me a hand job. She's like an old man. Bleeding a radiator. Oh yes, it's getting hot at the bottom. Oh, the heat's rising. Oh, there we go. Not to be here for another year. Fantasy sex is good, though. That's so sexy. To have fantasies, even if you don't do it. Jimmy, what's your sexual fantasy? Can I go ahead and raise the mood there about the thinking of sexy fantasy in the sexy way? Come on, Jimmy, share it. Me, Reiner. Descriptions I fucking give it. To go see if he's got an appointment. It's funny, sexual fantasies and stuff like that, in here they sound great, but when you actually bring them into the real world, it can be fucking different. I said to my wife, listen, will you pretend to be a nurse? So she pretended to be a nurse, and then I had to wait 18 hours to see her. And she went to Australia. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all for me.